Today, we are going to be going over my least favorite cars in GTA 5 Online. I made a video recently of my favorite cars in the game, and you guys seem to enjoy that, and some of you guys were asking me to make a video on my least favorite cars, so that's what we're going to be doing today. Now, the cars in this video, I just don't really like for my own personal reasons, and it's not really because they're terrible in terms of performance, and some of them I don't truly hate, but we'll get into that in the video. So with that said, I hope you enjoy, and let's get into it. One of my least favorite cars in the game is the X80 Proto. This car is the 7th most expensive supercar in the game, or 7th most expensive car in the game, and it was actually the most expensive car for a very, very long time. It also tends to take flight a lot while racing, but that issue has been somewhat fixed as the years went on, but this isn't why I hate this car, okay? It was released as a car in the Finance and Felony update, and a month later, the Cunning Stunts update came out. So many people bought the car because back then it was actually pretty decent and it looked really, really cool. But the handling was so bad, they kept losing and not doing that well in races. After that, the car was then defined as the troll car, and anytime you would go into a race and you saw an X80, they would just troll you, and that happened every single time you were in a stunt race. If you saw an X80 Proto, they were the ones trolling, they were the ones that were driving backwards, they were the ones that would literally hit you for no reason, come in dead last, and get DNFs left and right. It doesn't really happen as much anymore because, for one, not many people play races unless they're double money. It's only the people that really love racing in GTA 5, like me and a bunch of other people, that will continuously play races. And because of that, there aren't really that many trolls. And the only time you'll see a troll is if they start to do really bad in a race. And nowadays, it's never really someone just in an X80 Proto, but this whole issue was a couple years ago, and that is pretty much why I hate the car, just because of those memories that I've had in the past with the X80, and I've always hated it since then. I have to admit, it's a pretty cool Ferrari in real life, but I just hate the car. The next car that I really don't like that much is the Progen Tyrus. When this car came out, it was the most expensive between the RE7B and the ETR1, which were obviously the racing cars from the Cunning Stunts update. It had the lowest top speed and acceleration out of these cars and the second worst handling. Back when the Cunning Stunts update came out, the RE7B was overpowered and was the fastest car in the game. The ETR1 was amazing too, and it was the cheapest by far. The Tyrus was just an expensive car that really wasn't that good. And for some reason, you also can't take off that huge spoiler on the back, and the sunstrip sticker isn't removable either, which is just kind of annoying. The entire car isn't terrible, but I just never really liked it because of those reasons. It was just such an expensive car, and the other two cheaper cars were much better than this one, and I really didn't see a purpose for why it was so expensive, and it was also a lot older than the other two cars. I get it's a very nice car, and in real life it's probably very expensive, but it's an older vehicle, and the other two vehicles were much newer and more advanced, and they were also more powerful, so it's just weird for why it was so much more expensive when the power and performance just really wasn't there. And I just really never liked the vehicle. If you want skins and V-Bucks in Fortnite, want to become max level in Call of Duty, need money in GTA 5, or anything else for a ton of other games, check out Digizani down below in the description and get 10% off your order by using code Frolics at checkout. Next up is the Vetto Classic, and it's probably the vehicle I hate most in this entire game, and it's for a couple of reasons. Number one, the fact that if you didn't get it for free when it was released, you'll never get it for free again. And honestly, most of the reasons are actually kind of about Rockstar, not specifically about the vehicle. But anyways, yeah, if you didn't get it for free when it was free for a week, you never get it for free again. They said, we will get a free special vehicle. I thought it would be like the Elegy, how it's just a free vehicle in the game that anybody can get whenever they wanted to. And let's say that actually happened, that would be pretty cool, because then the Vetto Modern would have been the vehicle or the go-kart that you have to buy. And it just kind of sucks, because imagine you were busy the week that the vehicle was free, then there was no way for you to get it. Then you would come back into the game and be like, hey, where's the free vehicle? And everybody's gonna be like, oh, you missed it, you could pay $800,000 to buy this little go-kart. That's another issue, the price, $895,000 to buy this thing, and then an extra $100,000 to buy the modern version. Like, I just think it's annoying. I think this vehicle should have stayed free. But the biggest thing that I hate about this vehicle, or not specifically about the vehicle, more with Rockstar, is the fact that there's no races for it. And I honestly think this is a big issue with the go-karts, because when the F1 cars came out, they came out with the open wheel races and it was awesome. So when we heard we were gonna get go-karts, we all just imagined go-kart races, and we were like, holy shit, that's gonna be so fun. They could literally turn that into a mini DLC, and it will be better than half the DLCs we've gotten in GTA 5. I'm not gonna lie, having go-kart races will be pretty awesome. But then we never got them. We were disappointed. And then we realized we can't even use the go-karts in races. If we wanted to make a race in the creator, there is no way that you can actually use the go-karts in the races, which I think is stupid. The stupidest thing ever. Like, why is that even a thing? I don't understand why we can't use a go-kart in a go-kart race, make it specifically only for go-karts and nothing else. And it would have been awesome. Even if we could make our own, it would be really cool. If Rockstar released them, obviously they would be a lot better, but we can't even use them in our own custom races if we wanted to. I've tried it, and you just cannot select it as a class for your vehicles. Even if you select sports cars, because for some reason they're classified as sports cars, then they just won't pop up on the list. I think it's really annoying, and honestly, I've just never received any kind of good stuff from the go-karts. The only thing I like is the modern version, because it kind of looks like a real go-kart, and I like it, but honestly, I drove it around for a little while and then never touched it again. It's just not one of my favorite vehicles, but I really wish there was races, and it definitely ruined the go-karts for me, because then they would have been a lot more fun. The next vehicle I've never been a huge fan of is the Zaba. And when it came out, I actually thought it was kind of cool, but also a little bit weird, because I was on Instagram and I saw an ATV, which is what the Zaba is, and it looked exactly like it, like identical, and then it came out in GTA 5, and I was like, what the fuck is happening here? Anyways, when the vehicle was released, I was driving it around and I was like, this thing sucks. Like, I was driving it, and it loses traction really quickly. It's not too fast. Then when I drove it in the water, it was going like 20 kilometers or 20 miles per hour, which is not that great. And I get it's a big vehicle and stuff, and we couldn't even change the tires on it, which was kind of annoying, unless you did like an F1 or a merge glitch, so then you could get tires on it. But honestly, I just never really liked the vehicle all that much. There was no weaponry. It could survive a lot of missiles, which I guess is kind of cool. So the only thing you would ever really use the Zaba for is if you're trying to deliver product to your business or something, you could use it as a shield, but that means you're gonna have to drive as fast as the Zaba drives, which is pretty slow. So it's gonna take a lot longer. Can somebody tell me what the actual purpose of this vehicle is? Like, does it actually do anything other than drive really slow in water and serve as just this giant piece of poo driving around on gigantic wheels that can just take a lot of missiles? I really don't see a point of it. It's like the Night Shark, but a lot worse, because the Night Shark's got a little bit more speed, it's got a little bit more armor, and it also has weaponry on it. So I've just never been a fan of the Zaba. I'm not sure how many of you guys like it either, but I've just never been a fan. And finally, the Bambushka. I've never really been a fan of this vehicle. When I first saw it though, I thought this thing looks sick and it's gonna be awesome, because you could sit in the nose of the plane and I believe you can control some guns or something like that. Like, I know there's a couple turrets on this thing, which is pretty cool, and it's pretty much a gunship like in Call of Duty, which is awesome. But I've never been a huge fan of it. For one, it's expensive as hell. It's the second most expensive plane in the entire game, right around $6 million. And if you put upgrades, it's definitely a little more than that, but if you unlock the trade price, I think it's only like $5.5 million with full upgrades. But still, I just don't really like it. It's really slow. I get it, it's a big plane, but like, it's really, really slow. Like, if you wanna fly across the map with this thing, bro, that shit's gonna take way too damn long. And it's cool that you can open the back door, but if you put any upgrades on it, you aren't even able to drive a vehicle in there. So if you wanna actually use it just because it has that back door that you could like store a car in or something, you can't upgrade it at all, which sucks. And if you wanna upgrade it, then the back door just becomes useless, which just sucks again. And even if you wanna put stuff in the back of it, in a live stream, I got a bunch of you guys to go and sit in the back and grab your motorcycles and grab cars and just drive in there, and everybody fell out of it. every person, when I opened the back door, they weren't even in there. They were all just scattered across the map, which sucked. So I really just don't like the plane. I'm not a huge fan of it. And to be honest, I think the Titan's better, even though it doesn't have a lot of stuff on it. If I just want a big plane, I'd buy that or that new one we got, the Alchemist or whatever it's called. That shit's pretty sick and it's fun to fly around. It's fast, it's very agile, and it looks really weird in cinematic mode if you start going up and down. I love that plane, but the Bombushka, I just do not like. Well guys, those are the vehicles that I don't really like in GTA 5. I'm very curious to see what vehicles you don't like in GTA. Be sure to comment them down below in the comment section. And obviously I'm very thankful for Rockstar for still putting out updates after 8 years, which is awesome because GTA is a really fun game, but some of the vehicles haven't been that great. And honestly, a lot of the other vehicles are really awesome. It's just these ones are the ones I just don't really love too much. And I'm sure there's some of you guys that don't love certain vehicles in the game. So comment them down below. I'm curious to know what you guys don't like. But anyways, thank you guys for watching, and I'll catch you guys in the next video.